Hey, welcome to another video. In this video, I'm going to show you how to work with the Aqua brush pen. I will tell you how it is constructed, how to fill it, and how to paint with it. So you can see how easy it is to take it with you for outdoor painting or during a weekend getaway. So keep watching. This is the brush pen and it has a cap to protect the tip, which I recommend using. You can unscrew the body and fill it with water. If you're outside, you can fill it with a pipette. Simply take the water from your drinking bottle. And if you are at home, you can also hold it under the tap. Then screw it back together. It's important to note that with some brands, the brush pen closes in the opposite direction. Now I will show you how to paint with it. Now I'll show you how to mix the paint. I have a cloth handy, but I'll also show you how to use a sponge. What I'm doing now is pressing on the body and letting a drop of water fall onto my paint to activate it, so you can mix it on your palette. Now I want to clean the tip of my brush. I do it by squeezing the body again and letting a few drops fall onto the sponge. Then I clean my brush in it. The brush and sponge are very useful when painting with children. It helps to prevent water spilling on the table. You can also drop a few drops onto your cloth or kitchen paper. It works the same way. Only a sponge lasts longer, but both methods work. It's up to you. Wet on dry technique. Now I will show you how to create a gradient. This means we will painting wet on dry. Pick up the paint from your palette and without applying pressure, place the brush on the paper and work slowly downwards. If all goes well, the water should flow a little. Now I will press in the brush and the color transition will be faster because more water is added. This technique is actually easier than doing it with a regular brush and water. Now I'd like to show you how you can work wet on wet with the brush pen. Both the paper and the paint are wet. I will squeeze the body to drop a few drops onto the paper. Then I will spread the drops on the paper with the brush. To see exactly where you have been, you can tilt the paper a bit. The shiny areas indicate where you have been. Now I will show you what happens when I drop a drop of paint on the paper. You will see that it spreads. Wet on wet gives less control, but you can create very natural paintings with it. You can also drop more water into the paint and the paper if you find a spot too dark. The more you experiment with it, the better the results. If you want, you can also lift some paint off the paper with a clean damped brush. When you paint nature scenes, you often want to capture the sun's shimmering. You can do this beautiful with a dry brush technique. Place your dry brush with some paint on the paper and stroke it in one straight motion across the paper. When you are done painting, always make sure to clean the tip properly. If you are only using a sponge or cloth, you should rinse it with water when you are at home. You will notice that the tip won't be transparent anymore, but it won't release any paint after rinsing. If you leave them for a while, make sure you empty the body because it can eventually get clogged with the dirt and paint. I recently discovered how to fix it, so if you are interested, I can make a video about it. Let me know in the comments. For now, that's a bit too much. I would suggest buying a nice brush pen, or maybe you already have one. And enjoy painting outdoors. Have fun, and I am curious to see what you will paint. I hope you find this video helpful. If so, please give it a thumbs up. And in the coming weeks, I will be posting more videos about outdoor painting. Do you like that? Then subscribe to my channel. I hope to see you again, and for now, have a creative day. Bye!